Hello, so let's talk a little bit about vendors today. Probably one of the big questions people are asking is, should you make a base near the vendor? Well, it's actually a good idea for the beginning to make a base near the vendor, but don't invest too much in it, because you need a lot of stuff near your base. For example, you need access to another point of interest or two. The way this design is laid out over here, it's a great place for a base. You can probably set up in the gun shop, so you can put all of your guns on the gun rack, so you can see what you have. And that's a great idea, but remember that the points of interest will spawn zombies, so the bigger and the more points of interest around your base, the more zombies you'll get. For example, my base is over here, where I started. So when I started, I went over here, fixed myself a car, fixed everything I needed, got all of the resources, looted all the areas around my city. And that was a much better choice, because the city will have everything you need. You have even smaller gun shops that don't show on the map, and the supermarkets also help a lot with food and other things. But this would have been a good base location over here in the gun shop, and you could have looted the entire area. But at the same time, keep in mind, loot is not everything in the game, because in the end game you'll only need one gun of each, and basically ammunition is recyclable, so you'll need raw materials. And besides, fuel is very, very limited in the game, so you might want to choose a more central location. Might be the central city, near some points of interest, but don't build it near the radiation, that will be annoying. And you also need to visit all of the vendors and some of the container yards, plus you need to destroy all of the hearts, plus you need to go to the eastern side of the map to fix the boat. So yeah, it can be tedious, so I recommend you choose a central location for your base, preferably inside the city like this. Because you'll find a lot more useful things in it. Also, the computer will probably be on the eastern side. I don't know, it depends where you spawn mostly. But if you... there are disadvantages and advantages being building near the trader. Okay, so what should you sell to the trader? First of all, I tried to see a lot of options, but to be honest, there are not a lot of options. For example, the high energy laser gun and the Tesla gun don't sell for a lot of money. It's actually pretty accurate, the price that you see on them. So this is 2,300, so that means half of that. So the best things to sell are of course the airbows and the mechanical airbows. Now to be honest, if you are making them, it's not a big difference between them. I think the airbow will need 5 more wood. Other than that, it's basically the same recipe. Metal parts versus metal components are basically the same, except you need an advanced. Doesn't matter, it's basically the same thing, so I recommend you just go for whatever you want, or the mechanical airbow, so you don't use the wood. And in pristine condition, as you can see, they are worth the most amount of money. So yeah, this is your best option to sell stuff. Sadly, there's not really a big reason to have money in the game right now. So let's sell that. As you can see, durability of the item matters a lot. They might as well repair it. And that's basically it. As you can see, everything else is super, super cheap in the game and not even worth selling. You can probably sell the gas masks, but for what you need, that's not enough. Now, the other question. Should you buy items from the vendor? Of course, but what items? Well, of course, for the collector in you, you should always buy the guns you don't have, but this is why I recommend you check the traders. If you can, check multiple traders, because some of them will have items on sale. For example, the M249 machine gun is on sale. On sale means it's, I think, 50% off. Might be more than 50% off, I don't know. I mean, you can buy it and I can show you. This is 4,800. Very good item, right? But yeah, generally I don't recommend you farm too much, because money is kind of free in the game, and if you sell just 10 mechanical airbows, that's probably enough to get your gun collection started and finished. Maybe you'll need to do 3 trips with 10 mechanical airbows, and that'll be enough for the entire game. So you basically buy the guns you need for your collection. You also probably will need one draw magazine or two, depends if you found them or not, but usually the 9mm you can find very easy. Of course, buy ammo. In my opinion, you should buy over the 5.56 ammo, because and the drums, because you saw how good the machine gun is. I mean, you can also play with the RPK, but the extended magazines only have 40 bullets in the magazines. This is 40 bullets. I guess I could show you. It's also worth buying multiple types of guns just because you want to switch calibers, so you don't always repair the, or don't always refill the same bullets over and over and over. I found that the RPK magazines are pretty rare with their 75 capacity. So, you can go for it. Now, what else should you buy from here? Well, in my opinion, the first thing you should buy from the trader, first of all, beyond anything, is the grenades. The grenades are amazing. Just buy all of them because they are so good and will avoid a lot of nonsense. For example, you can kill elites with them, you can kill hordes of zombies, you can kill also yourself with them, so be careful. Frag grenades will be my first purchase. My second one will be the laser sights, especially if they are on sale. The laser sights are amazing. They make the game feel a lot better. I'll show you in a bit. After that, I would buy everything that has extended on it. Extended rifle barrel. Shotgun short barrel is also very good for damage. Just buy anything that gives you damage. Also, the 9mm long barrel. It's 65. It's super cheap. And you can use it as consumable. I no longer repair my attachments and some of the other things. So, yeah, the lasers, the extended barrels, sometimes the suppressors, depends on how you want to play. The suppressors also add a little bit of damage. The shotgun stuff to make a super good shotgun in case you need it inside of a building or something else. And then maybe some of the other things, but remember, the sights will decrease the stats of your gun and also your stats. Let me show you in a bit. And after that, well, like I said, complete your collection of guns. The Colt is a very good weapon, like I always used. I probably only use the Colt just because of the high damage and very good reliability. And also, you can put a dry magazine on the Colt in the game because you don't need realism. So 60% more damage, and they're kind of annoying to repair with because they need glue. 70% more damage. The optical sight, as you can see, reduces your fire rate, but if it's a bolt action, it doesn't really matter. Light range, sight FOV, and the offset decreases your offset, which is basically how accurate you'll shoot to the target. I don't know, that's how I understand it. So if your offset is too much, you will not really be able to aim your gun. That has an offset of 2, this has an offset of 4. I guess I cannot load it because I don't have any ammunition. But let's show you this one, the pistol. Offset is 2. Speed is pretty accurate right now because of my skills as well, so I don't really miss anymore, or I don't have a lot of variation anymore. So you can basically offset the offset with that one. And that's everything you need to know about the traders and basically all of the tips I have. Now let's go and see some of the guns I have and we'll shoot all of them if we can. Otherwise we'll just mouse over them and that will be a lot of fun as well. It's also worth noting that this might change over time, so you might have better luck with some items. But anyway, I think the traders have a very important role to play in the game, but at the same time, after a while, they stop being important as well. I think they have infinite money, but they might also restock over time. I'm not sure about that. They seem to restock sometimes. But I'm also playing for 50 hours in this save, so don't know about that. Okay, so let's switch something more interesting. So let's try to fire these guns. It'll be messy, so I'll have to reload after this because it's super annoying. Yes, AR-15. Come on. Modify. It looks very cool for what it is. Tell you we don't have zombies around. Sounds very cool, even without the suppressor, without anything. Very cool gun. Also, these are some of the strongest. The Ruger 300 Magnum, 0.300 Magnum. See what happens when you fire guns? This is what happens when you fire guns. Imagine some full auto. Now, since this is bolt loaded, oh, I don't have a magazine in it, so I have to reload every time. It's also a lot more useful to use the CIS system. Also remember to move while using the CIS system, move backwards, otherwise your character seems to always move forward for whatever reason. A jam. Also, this is the hit system. If it fills up, you can no longer fire that gun. Well, my kingdom for a weapon. Anyway, we have seen those. Probably it's time to switch to the RPK. Remember, every gun needs a magazine, but the bolt loaded ones can be a little easier to use if you just insert the magazine into them. Winchester, okay. Yeah, let me show you that for a moment. And with my skills, I can load two of them in the barrel, in the gun. It should also be 5 plus 1, but I'm not sure how that works. Probably it's one in the barrel already, let me see. No, it doesn't work like that, so I'm not sure why it says 5 plus 1, because you can only load 5. So yeah, this probably is enough gun for everyone. Remember, single fire, double fire. That's the sound of victory. Again, I'll not speak too much about attachments, I'll cover that in another video. Oh yeah, let's also cover the beautiful guns, which are the ones you can get from the mechs. Guns, they're not as good as you might think, and they can be really annoying because of their range. The Tesla has a pretty short range. Oh, never mind, take that back. It has a long range. But the damage is kind of lacking. Bulk damage is useful, but as you can see, it's not quite enough. Plus also, if you set them on fire, it's kind of an annoying effect. It should also slow them down, so the Tesla should slow them down, because that's what electricity is, but I don't see this effect most times anyway. Eh. And besides, these guns seem to be weaker against the normal zombies. This is where grenades would come into play. Now, if you're in trouble, just go into the car and wait. Yeah, they're kind of interesting guns, but I think some skills are missing or some upgrades are missing because I don't think they should be that weak. Okay, let's get something else. I feel like in John Wick, in the part where they get assaulted in the hotel and they use different guns and take little breaks here and there. Might also prefer the shotguns because they're much easier to handle. But probably the noise will attract even more mutants and zombies. Now this is the short shotgun. Does a lot of damage, but sadly it's kind of spread out. Okay, who wants to get some of this? Well, that's not even the heart. Well, I don't want to open the heart up because it will be an invasion of zombies. Okay, that's super dangerous. Let's not do that again. Ah. So this thing can do 600 damage per shot normally. And as you can see, without much offset. And also because of my increased accuracy from the skills, and also because it can fire faster. Look at the recoil, it pushes my character back. Plus one reload. Oh, okay, so this one has one. Yeah, so the extra bullet will appear over here. Oh, it's such a cool gun. Let's also use the striker. The striker is more or less the same thing, except you cannot modify it. Slightly better fire rate. But it becomes so accurate. Sadly, it will jam because it overheats when you simply do it like that. Yes, shotguns are cool. Let's throw them on the floor. Yeah, it would be so much worse just to do all of this again. Ah, the katanas. Don't have anything to say about the katanas. So let's go over here to this crate. I don't really have enough time to show everything. MP5, MP9, PSS, AK-47, 50 cal. I want to hear the 25, I want to hear it as well, the VSS. Now let's take some magazines off. Well, oh yeah, let's check this out. So the RPK is very good also because you can take the magazine off it. So the 50 cal, you can probably make the bullets for it, it's going to be annoying. And that's the 0.25 pellet. As you can see, we really have improvised bullets. Pretty cool, I like the sound of it. It really sounds like a big gun, like it should. And then you just load, load, and load. I think that bounced back and hit me. Yes, you can get yourself killed with grenades or other things in the game. Also, all the magazines are compatible between the caliber guns, so 7.62 will become compatible. It sounds exactly as it should. Well, I think the ball should sound more than the... should have a lower sound, more like a pea shooter, but it's pretty close, I like it. I like that a lot. Okay, so the guns sound pretty good in the game. And just remember, it's a matter of options and opinions and whatever you want to use. Because at the end of the day, everything will kill a zombie, and that's what I like about the game. It's not... I think it's really overpowered. You can use whatever you like. Okay, let's use the Chris and the Mutant and also the AK-47. I guess you can also use this one. I probably need to get some magazines and reload some of this. And those are my extra guns I have. Yeah, I'm not going to details about some of the other things because it's a lot of things to say about, but let's just use more guns. For example, to reload these magazines you need quite a bit of time, so again, it all comes down to the skill system, like I keep saying. It really helps a lot. Especially because you will probably want to use all of the things at your disposal. And by that I mean the bolt actions, the machine guns and so on. And sometimes, I think at some point I used to spend about 1 hour every night just organizing my inventory because it was so annoying. MP5. Sounds exactly as you'd expect. So keep in mind you can press and hold R to switch the magazine you want. It's almost like Tarkov. And now the Mutant. Wait, what is this? Oh, because it's a semi-auto, okay. But that looks pretty automatic to me if you press the mouse button fast enough. Okay, so I guess some guns will sound the same. I'm running out of ground. Ooh, I like how this one sounds. Very cool design. I guess you can shoot some of the smaller guns as well. Let's see what's in the barrel. Imagine cleaning all of this up. Someone said they would like multiplayer in this game. Yeah, imagine being the guy that has to clean all of this up. Probably I should use the tower as well and the Chris and the Uzi maybe as well. I will not fire the bows because they're more or less the same. As for the pistols, probably the Luger, well, that's not really a Luger, but looks like one. .22, the Colt Chauffeur, the revolvers maybe. There's also the auto Glock. Ah, sure, why not? My accidental press to clear. Sorry about this, it's just a little bug. It's not really a bug, it's kind of a feature, but hey. Okay, I think we have ammo for all of these. Oh, I like how the vector sounds. Suppressed all of the guns more or less sound the same, so that's why I'm not using them suppressed. No recoil, I like that. You can also basically have a backup gun that will be kind of like the opposite. For example, if you have an automatic weapon, you should probably use a semi-auto pistol. If you have a shotgun as your main, you should probably have an automatic pistol. Stuff like that. Out of ammo? Never out of ammo. Probably one of the coolest guns. Yeah, the way they drop the shells, yeah, some of the animations are just amazing. Those will probably have a lot of kick to it. Not really, more or less like the others. So you can do this clear weapon, which will remove the magazine. Okay, the last one will be the revolver. Oh yeah, I forgot how much of a beast this thing is. Not really good per se, but the way it sounds, it's amazing. Let's give it a full magazine and let's fire the entire magazine. Ah, such a fun little adventure. And we still have a lot of things to do in the game. I think this gun should have a little more damage. The fire rate and everything else is... it's amazing. Why does this sound so cool? It sounds, well, almost like a space gun, but... let's listen to that again. Come on, finish up already. As you can see, I'm reloading two bullets or two air pellets, because that's my skill. So this is technically kind of like a top loading gun. Sounds so cool. Probably, yeah, we're loading two bullets into this one as well. Small, cute. Not really loud. They also said they plan to introduce 50 caliber, which will be a lot of fun, the Barrett, sniper rifle, and maybe some bigger calibers as well. Okay, that's about it. See you next time. Bye bye.